I may need to borrow someone's pencil too at some point.
Yep.
Oh, yes, perfect. Thank you.
Noise.
Noise?
Noise.
With a capital.
Noise.
Noise.
Yeah, capital. Noise.
Noise. Yeah.
Noise. All right,
oh,
cool.
That's a bad roll.
So we're live.
Rock and roll!
Is this a thing? Are
yeah.
we doing a thing
really?
Now? Is this going to be a thing every time?
Yeah.
Have you turned Cast into a noise marine?
Turned into?
You're in the wrong universe. The wrong universe.
All right, so hey everyone, we are live with Warhammer Fantasy Roleplay here at the Harry Tarantula. Check us out at harryt.com.
I'm getting hard.
Now, so we're actually starting a little late tonight, and that's because we just finished the Star Wars X-Wing Hyperspace Trial Final. So, funny story, it was a 14-hour long event on Saturday. However, the venue required us to vacate the premises, so we were able to finish the quarterfinals, but we didn't finish the finals until today, and that was because the players and that. So tomorrow, I look forward to doing a bunch of tournament paperwork. So,
yay!
That's my day.
Paperwork.
For tomorrow. And then we have Star Trek Adventures tomorrow night. So that'll be fun.
But it's not streamed, so you're fine.
It's not streamed though, but if you want to come in store and check it out, you are more than welcome. I am the DM for that. If you want to see what Star Trek Adventures was all about, you can hop over onto our YouTube channel, Harry Tarantula, and check that out. It's under the VODs, I believe.
Yeah.
Or the RPGs. It's
yeah.
In one of those playlists. For the most part, we are playing Warhammer Fantasy Roleplay tonight with our beautiful DM who had got a haircut.
Yeah.
He's no longer.
Now I just need to do the rest of it.
Just do the rest of it, yeah.
Like bleach it and redye it.
So I redyed my hair to the lovely shade of black, and So I missed a spot while dyeing it. So I have this silver streak right here. It's like,
just going like full Reed Richards over there.
Go Reed Richards there.
Yeah.
All right, so we finished the starter adventure, right?
Oh, yeah, part of it. Finished the introductory adventure.
Yeah, and so what's happening tonight?
So tonight we're going to go through your little downtime actions, because you have a few weeks to recover, recuperate, find work, things like that. You know, deal with.
Righto.
Okay. Never gonna get old.
Absolutely
well
never gonna
then.
Get old. Everyone loves it. Never gonna get old.
Deal with things. And then. Once that's done, we'll go back into standard things. Standard adventures.
Standard adventuring.
Yeah, until you get to your next downpost.
I'm just adjusting the camera a little bit. It was too far over to the left, and
so,
no one was centered.
Oh, nice. First thing we're going to discuss is your ambitions.
To take over the world.
Well, I was thinking I'd like to move into a nice house, get married after college, and then get an SUV with a white picket fence and maybe have 2.5 children.
I've never understood that. What is the 0.5? The baby?
Halflings.
Halflings.
Halflings, yeah.
All right.
It's statistical average. Yeah. Some people have like 2, some have 3,
some have 20.
That's hilarious.
Those are people bringing up the average. That's all. Just bringing up the average.
I guess if I wanted to get more specific, I could have been like 2.43 children.
We cut them off at the waist.
I think the important thing here is he has up to date stats on it. Before he showed up today, he's like, wait, let me research these jokes.
Character ambitions. So you need to think about your, because some of you didn't have this, like we didn't do this at Character Gen. So you need to think about your short-term ambition.
Cool.
Short-term is something that you can generally complete in 2 to 3 sessions.
Okay. I believe I've completed my short-term.
Yeah, you've completed yours. You're probably going to complete yours when you spend the extra
to learn to cook.
Yeah.
Yes.
So effectively, you get a rebate of 50 XP.
Yeah!
When you complete your short-term ambition, you get 50 XP.
Okay.
Long-term ambitions are exactly that, long-term. They'll take a very long time, if ever.
Yeah, the long-term ambitions for characters seemed interesting. So we get 50 XP for completing our short terms?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Only you and you had short terms to begin with.
Okay.
Now I need to pick a new short term. Now you need to pick a new short term ambition. Right.
Mm. Oh, damn. That's right.
Then we have party short term ambition. So, what your short term ambition is as a party.
I mean, we didn't destroy the watch.
Yet.
Yet.
And what your long term ambition is as a party.
Destroy the watch harder.
Once we destroy it, we're going to bend it over and destroy it again.
Destroy it.
We're going to salt the earth upon which the watch was built.
Rebuild us a new watch so that we may destroy it again from the inside.
Something else you need to think about is your motivations, which is under your resilience.
Well, I do believe it, sir. I only have two motivations here. I call it lefty and righty.
Motivations are... When you roleplay out your motivations, that's how you regain your resolve.
Oh, interesting.
So, fortune recovers at the start of every session.
Yes.
Resolve only recovers when you act in accordance to your motivation. So if you never act in accordance, it's gone for good.
You mean I have to write a whole motivation in this teeny tiny box? Box.
It's a motivation in a word, though.
In a word?
Yeah, or two
words.
Yeah,
I mean, my motivation is thrill seeker. Hence, you know, running into a burning building.
To loot the place.
Yeah. That's a thrill.
That's a thrill. Yeah. That's true. Yeah. Did you have resolve to build back up again, or was that just for fun?
No, none of that. And then he fell out of a building. And it was on fire.
There we go. Okay.
Which I ended up spending one of my life points for.
Yeah, life points. Yeah.
So Einrich's real name is Thrill House, is what you're saying.
Thrill House.
Welcome, Thrill Ho.
So have a think about what your short-term ambitions are.
Okay. Mm.
Considering stuff that has now gone on, so you've got a bit more background to work with, things like that. Have a think about what your long-term ambitions are. Your long-term ambition, for instance, is to...
I want to eat a dragon's heart.
Yeah.
What?
I haven't yet run into one, but I feel like it would be delicious.
All right. Your long-term ambition is?
To build my own bounty hunter guild.
Yeah. Cool. So it's that kind of thing. It's like a life ambition. If you complete your long-term ambition, you get either a choice of a lot of bonus XP, and you choose a new long-term ambition, or the character retires and becomes a permanent ally to the party.
Cool.
And you get half of that character's XP towards your next character.
Oh, those are cool options.
Yeah. Okay, right. That's the game I was trying to figure out what we get half XP for.
Yeah.
Because I kept thinking it was Gloomhaven.
No, so like... if you meet your doom, so if your doom happens to you, mm-hmm. which is another thing some of you have to think about.
Nope.
Not you.
Nope.
It's doomed because you're human.
Yeah.
If you meet that doom and you die from it,
okay.
So you don't spend fate points to recover, or you don't have any fate points left, then you get half your current character's XP towards your next character. All right. Otherwise,
that's so fun.
If you start a new character, you start with basic starting XP.
Oh, okay.
You do not gain
20, right?
Which is whatever you get from character gen.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if you choose to pick everything, then it's nothing.
Yeah.
Right. So there is no bonus XP for like being in a game for 2 years, and then we died, or two of us died, but it wasn't through our fate, our ambitions, or it wasn't through our dooms. We start off with basic starting character skill.
I see.
Like if your doom is to die in a fire, and then you're in a game for 2 years, and then you suddenly drown at sea.
That's nice.
Yeah. Let that be a lesson. Don't go out to sea.
Yeah.
All right.
It hates you. It doesn't want you to be there.
Issue. It's apparently desyncing.
The audio is desyncing, or the?
We're getting chatter from the chat, but it's desyncing.
Okay.
So, hold on.
Let you sort that.
Oh, no, no. Just use. Because I will use until the dice fail me. Then I will choose a new
string.
Their audio is decent.
Try these ones. Okay.
Thank you, Greg.
No, that problem. Never happens on JP string.
Gotcha.
Dude's been streaming for like 5 years.
All right, so I think that should resolve it. Okay, so...
So yeah, have a think about what your short-term ambition is. Have a think what your long-term ambition is.
What's the cost for buying cooking? Is cooking a skill?
So we'll get to this. It'll be a downtime action for you because it's normally outside of your thing.
Got it. Okay, fair enough.
And then as a group, you need to think about what your short-term and long-term ambitions are.
Okay. Well, we're no longer in that sweet job we had.
No.
And it's going to be hard to destroy
and
the
ambitions
the
are
outside.
Generally not attached to the plot.
It's what we want to do with ourselves.
It's what you want to do with yourselves, not what fate wants to do with you.
I've got it.
Okay, so...
Ponzi scheme.
I've already figured mine out, actually.
You don't have to tell everyone.
Okay. You guys, I need you to plug your ears.
No, just write it down.
Or I'm spoiling Endgame.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I plugged my ears. Somebody needs to let me know when to stop.
So, let's continue.
You can just write it down and, like, write it on the back or the front or whatever.
Okay.
So, you have several weeks of downtime.
Okay. I would like to go drinking and whoring.
That's a given. This is why, unless you go banking, you lose all your money.
Well, too bad I decided to put my money aside in a bank.
Yeah, so that will be one action, downtime action. You each get 3 downtime actions.
I will deposit the majority of my money with the exception of 6 shillings and 26.
Oh, that's so specific.
Yeah, so here's the thing. Any you keep aside vanishes.
No, I have the 20 gold, I'm leaving
the
lawyer.
Yeah, so like...
Oh no, sorry.
Yeah, you have to do it with an actual bank.
I have to do it with an actual bank because, and I believe I'm wagering 1% because I have to wager something.
Yeah.
Alright, so mine is going into a bank.
Okay, so, first of all, let's quickly write these down.
As a party goal, do you want to like try and take revenge on Rudy? I mean, I get what? That he was your buddy and like
rival.
Completely, I mean, friend.
Yeah,
of me,
I know that you and Rudy were like best friends.
Yeah, like this pretty much.
I don't know how I feel about like we wanted to know we'd have your permission first before we took him down because we know that you guys were tight. You're like blood brothers.
I don't think that's how that works, but sure.
Frenemies?
Okay, I can accept the frenemy. Yeah.
Your downtime actions. What you can do is downtime. None of your elves, so you don't lose one.
Sweet.
Elves lose downtime.
Another
action.
Good reason
guaranteed.
not to be an elf.
But they generally start with better stats.
Propensity for stabbing children, as we've seen.
Yeah. Mm. So
we're not going to discuss that.
Are we not?
You no. can train one of your animals if you have an animal.
Ooh, I do have an animal.
You can go banking.
I've gone banking.
You can... sorry. So if you are breast here, so you're like you and you two cannot invest your money. You can only stash your money.
Okay.
Because you don't have the
Status,
really.
Hope you have a good mattress.
You can change career. Like, if you're changing completely outside of your path. So, if you want to stop being a hunter and become a knight. It's completely outside, so it takes time to put things in order and meet the people, etc. that you need to do stuff. You can commission a item. This is how you get exotic items, because normally they, exotic items never show up in the shop.
Yeah.
Thanks for the cheer, Teresa Cello.
You can consult an expert
Teresa
because
Cello.
Teresa Cello, yes.
One of yours.
Hi, Teresa.
You. One of yours.
Mm.
Okay. So consult an expert allows you to consult experts to find out where you can get something commissioned, because certain things are so rare that you can only get them in certain parts of the world. Crafting, if you want to do any crafting. Income, so you can actually go out and earn some money for your next adventure.
Yeah.
Because as I said, you lose all your gold with drinking and whoring. All right,
gold
your
and,
adventures.
And silver. And
yeah, you lose all of your stash.
Yeah.
Unless you invest it or stash it somewhere. So you lose it all unless you go and work or stash it.
So for the money that we do have, can we buy items from the shop before we lose it all?
No.
It just assumes that if we have whatever money we have, we've spent it on drinking and whoring.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, what's the first
don't forget
thing
the blow.
You said?
Don't forget
what was the first thing you said when he's like, you have downtime activities? Drinking and whoring.
Yeah.
Like, I mean,
you kind of crossed your mind. Yeah. Even before going banking.
Then you were like,
Before the mechanics and ramifications of downtime had even been explained, the first place you went was drinking and whoring.
Yeah. So
the first place you went was
really
drinking and whoring. How would your mother feel knowing about you going around drinking and whoring all the time?
My mother accepts me for the lovely person I am.
You
we
can
have arguments, but still.
You can invent new droppings. So if you're like an engineer or something like that, you can like design and invent things. Training, the training endeavor, which is what you want to do.
I do,
because
yes.
you need want to learn cooking.
Yep.
Alright, so training allows you to learn skills and characteristics outside of what's allowed by your career. So if you want to learn willpower and increase your willpower, which I know one of you does, you have to do it through the training endeavor.
Okay.
Alright. If you want to learn a talent, then it's another endeavor completely. The unusual learning talent or endeavor for learning a talent. So it still costs 100 XP to buy the talent, and then you have to pay the teacher some shillings. And then you have to make a test based on what that talent is. So if you're learning to read and write, it's going to be an intelligence test. If you fail the test, you fail the endeavor. You can do it again, but you have to try again. But you get plus 10 to each attempt to try again. So it gets easier and easier.
Next
the more
downtime.
Time. It could be another endeavor within the same downtime.
So we get you were explaining earlier that we can train our animals?
Yes.
So what happens in animal training? Like, I have a hunting dog. Opens.
Yeah.
So what can I train my hunting dog to do?
So animal training allows
Display.
You to add a skill.
Quality defense.
So add a new trait to your trained animal.
You think we don't have any
training.
Russian viewers?
So it would allow you to...
I have committed atrocity.
Because you have a hunting dog. It could allow you to train the dog to...
cook.
3-4-2. So let me just find the list. Do things like...
roll over?
No. Like,
yes, me lord!
Like, fight. So you could use animal training to turn a hunting dog into a war dog. Things like that.
Oh, that sounds hot
right?
shit. I like that.
Yeah, and then next level you go war dog to hound
train,
of...
Train skills.
Redacted.
So yeah, you can make it become like a war dog or...
so
you can train it so it ignores wizards. When they start casting spells, because no animals like being around a wizard when they cast a spell. They don't care about priests, but wizards,
I feel like
however,
this is just rolling the dog up in a blanket and then holding it near Muscle Wizard while he starts casting stuff, and eventually it will run out of energy, you know, yelping and running away. It's called immersion therapy, and it works.
So yeah, those
super
are
unpleasant.
Not
the primary thing.
I'm totally sure it works that way.
That is exactly
how we'll
wrap how
it you works. Up in a blanket and put you near a demon and be like, don't worry.
And this is
fine.
In addition to spending your XP.
Cool.
I see.
So, you wish to bank?
Yes.
You wish to train your animal?
Yes.
What's your third one?
My third one will be to do the willpower thing to raise it up.
Okay.
To train.
Okay.
Train myself, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. So how does... I guess let's do this.
So your banking's done at 1%.
Okay.
That's what you chose, yeah?
Yes.
1% invested at... And however much, so 20 gold.
It's 20 gold at 1% invested.
Yeah. Animal training is make an average animal training test, so it's at plus 20.
So let me move the stuff from last night.
What are you training your dog to do?
I'm going to train it to sniff out cowards and chew them apart.
Oh, sniff out cowards?
You're first.
Yeah. Uh-huh. You don't say!
So what
instructions unclear. Yeah.
What skill do you want your dog to learn?
I want it to become a war dog.
A war dog.
And stream's over. War blacklisted.
A war dog, yeah. I want it to become a war dog.
So war, okay. Yeah.
Hello, war. FBI.
War dog.
War dog.
War dog. War dog. I'm gonna change his name to
Hordak. Okay. So make your animal training test.
All right.
So plus 20. Yes. I assume you have animal training.
I have. Let me just grab my correct sheet here.
Animal training is an advanced skill.
Is it an advanced skill? I have animal care.
No, it's an animal train.
So then I cannot train my dog.
If someone had animal training, you might be able to convince them to train your dog.
I don't yet have animal training.
You have animal care?
Yeah,
to train your animal, you must first train yourself.
Yes, that is correct.
Exactly that, yeah.
Sure.
Makes sense.
100% correct.
That is accurate.
So.
Okay, so banking. I can't train...
No, you want to train yourself, though, so it's some training.
Yep.
You are learning...
Willpower.
Willpower.
Yes. So I will not go whoring and drinking.
Okay, so it will...
You will sit in a room surrounded by whores and drink and just not partake. That is how you train.
I will not fall for this. Yes.
Sitting in the center of a room while, like, debauchery happens around you, sweating profusely.
Just like going just tomorrow. In the background noise, he's just FOMO.
So it's not a unusual thing to learn.
What, right? Willpower?
Yeah. It's not like necromancy or something like that.
Wait, I can learn necromancy?
No.
I
could
for that was exciting.
Unusual advanced talents or unusual advanced skills, you might have to consult an expert to find someone to teach you.
Okay.
Right. But for something like willpower, you can find a teacher quite easily. So therefore,
like
you
priest.
Can learn it. Yeah, like a priest or a wizard or something like that. Well, a priest, because there's only
yes, you don't
one
trust him.
Actual wizard in
don't trust
the
him.
Town.
Roll the 99, get rid of it.
There's
get
some other person, one actual
rid
wizard.
Of the high numbers now.
I believe I am what the citizenry refers to as a fraud.
So, you will need to... pay the person a whole... 6 shillings.
6 shillings?
Yeah.
Alright, can I haggle with them?
No.
It's fine. I will pay the 6 shillings.
Yeah. It's basically a flat line.
Okay.
Alright, and then you can learn willpower.
Also, I don't know if you really want to try haggling with someone who's teaching you willpower.
Oh no, sorry, my mistake. It's the XP you spend on the skill. In brass pennies. Plus 6.
Plus 6 shillings?
Plus 6 brass pennies.
Oh,
so
I have the 6 shillings still.
Yeah. So
okay.
How much XP are you spending on willpower?
I have 50 XP.
So that would be 25 and 25, so it would be 2. Right?
Two shillings.
No, it would be 2 advances.
Okay.
Because it's 25 per advance for your first 5 advances.
Gotcha, yeah.
All right. So it would cost you 56 brass pennies.
And a silver shilling is worth how much?
12 brass pennies. So 48 is 36, 48. So it's 4 and...
It's 5 silver shillings.
Yeah,
5 silver 12 shillings?
Times 5. 56.
Yeah, for 60. Yeah.
Oh, right. 60, sorry.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's, yeah, it's five, around six. Five
shillings. Sure. Let's say 5 shillings just because that makes sense.
Let's say you tip him.
Yeah.
You tip him.
Fine, I tip him.
So you did training, banking, anything else? Income?
Income.
Otherwise, you don't actually start your next adventure with any money.
Yeah, so let's do income generation.
Income's easy, we'll just remember. We'll do that when you actually start your adventures. Okay. So, you.
So I would like to learn training. To cook. So that's training. Is it a talent that's cooking?
No,
or?
Cooking is a skill.
Cooking is a skill.
Yeah.
So how much XP do I spend on that in order to...
I believe cooking is a skill.
In which case it would be...
It's an advanced skill, though.
It's an advanced skill.
Yeah.
Mm.
Because yeah, some of the advanced skills are weird.
Craft.
That's fine. I'm good with weird skills. I will be a master of weird skills. The worst hunter, but I'll know how to do all this other shit.
Yeah, it's a craftsman thing.
Cool.
Artisan. So artisan's good at it. It is... trade. Cook.
Trade. Cook.
And trades are advanced skills, so it costs you however much XP you're putting in.
How much is it per level?
For your first 5 advances is 10 XP per.
10 XP per?
Yeah.
I'll put in 5 advances into trade.
Okay,
cooking.
So that's 50 XP and 100 and 9 brass pennies.
109 brass pennies?
Yeah.
Good. Alright.
Joe, what's your first?
Okay, so I don't think Geffen really has much money, or any money, so I wanna do income first.
Okay.
So I wanna look for work and make some money.
Yeah, you should have some.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
Alright, I pay my 10 silver shillings.
Where do you write down your money?
It's back here under wealth.
I have 22...
Brass pennies. Okay.
Oh, okay.
So not a lot.
Yeah. So, well, either way, I'll still do the income thing. So this is what my character is going to do during our downtime.
Income just means you start with something. Okay.
Sweet. So income, for one. And then I want to stash my money.
Okay.
And then...
Sure. Or income.
you just go to work.
In the spirit of, like, self-improvement, I think Geffen has seen the benefits of reading and writing. Can I learn to read and write?
You can do that through normal XP expenditure.
Oh.
Because it's a talent for...
Got it. So then, other than that, then...
Yeah, you can just spend 100 XP and learn how to read and write.
Sweet.
You don't need to go see anyone special like these guys. You can learn it, too. I think you already have.
Yeah, I already.
Yeah.
I mysteriously became literate in the middle of a boss fight.
Then I'm not sure what my third thing can do. Okay.
Commission something.
Is it...
I learned how to
consult
shoot
an expert
and throw a bolus and track people in the middle of a boss
fight.
Wow.
Yeah, you can, like...
What would you
you don't have to spend all three, you know?
Okay. I think that's good for now.
So you stash?
Yeah. I just do the normal, you know, downtime stuff.
Income, you can do income multiple times.
Oh,
yeah,
yes.
You can do income. So income
Sweet.
Points, basically.
What's what characteristic does trade cooking use?
Whatever trade does. Have a look. Oh. Buy a book.
Sadness.
Mike,
all right, I'll find out later.
What do you want to do?
Okay, so for my first action, I would like to invest my money. Because I have 28 gold coins and I feel like I probably shouldn't let that go to waste.
Okay. Invest at what percentage?
1%. Like, Richard.
1%. Okay. Second?
I'd like to acquire my wizard's license. Or at least whatever trappings I still need for that.
Okay. That would be given to you at the end of the last thing.
Oh, okay.
So, from what's her name?
Fair. Okay. So I've got the license then?
From Heskey.
Okay.
Same as your bounty hunter trapping. That was kind of your reward for your service.
Ooh, fancy. Okay. Let's see. For the next one then... employment's going to be the third action. For the second one, I guess I will commission a new outfit for my character.
Ah, you want a
I assume something that has a lot of gold cloth and stuff on it.
A gold Speedo?
really conductive.
Probably not.
No.
But gold, because you're going into gold.
Yeah.
The, the gold wind.
Yeah.
Which means that if you're wearing a lot of gold, then you get a, or a lot of gold colored things, you get a bonus of plus 10 to your channeling tests.
Wow,
yeah.
Cool.
Or sorry, your plus 10 to your Winds of Magic tests,
yeah.
So your language magic things.
I may want to...
casting.
Actually, what I may commission is a design for a gold inlay on my armor.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now that's fancy.
You're not wearing plate though, are you? You're on chain.
That's true.
So you just replace some of the links with gold links.
Yeah.
Gold's the same as steel.
Gold. You can have gold weave, like gold.
Yeah.
Cool.
Thread.
It's going to look real nice when the next troll vomits on us.
Commission.
Why is that pile of vomit glittering? That is right. I've referred to my character as a pile of vomit. And this
so
is the first time on this stream.
How much
either.
Do you wish to spend on your
commission?
Commission, yeah.
I will spend 8 of my gold coins.
Okay. So you invest how much?
Total?
After that 8, how much do you invest?
Oh, invest?
Because you took the invest action. I just need to do it right now.
Okay.
You did 20.
Okay. So I've got 20... remaining, so
you
have
20.
Yeah,
okay.
And it was at a 1% investment rate.
Yeah, right? Both of you. Yeah, because you don't want to lose your money. Okay, so while you're doing these things in the 3 weeks,
Joe mentioned something earlier.
Yeah.
That what was it?
Spending XP? For
no,
reading,
earning income. So,
yeah.
I still have one action remaining.
Yeah.
So I'll
leave was income.
I'll earn income,
yeah.
Do I need to make a rule for that?
No, we'll get to that in a second.
Okay.
And your other two?
So, one's going to be the stash.
Stash?
27
yeah.
gold. Under a flagstone somewhere that only I feel I would know about, you know? So, like, hopefully
you
not the center of the market.
Yeah, you stash
I find a hole and
so
I bury
the
it.
So, the stashes... only run the risk of loss of the money when you check to take some of it out. So if you keep stashing lots of small amounts of gold or treasure all over the place, who knows until you return to it whether or not.
What's the
There's
chance?
No risk until... so the chance is a it's 10%
chance. 10%
chance
each time.
Yeah.
Okay, so I will...
However, it does not take a downtime action to withdraw any of your money.
Ooh.
All right? You can only do it during downtime, but it doesn't take downtime
can
action.
Can I stash my money in more than one place during the same downtime
no.
action? Okay,
darn. No.
That was my other... I was like, I store one gold in a
no.
variety of places.
Yeah, so
27
this amount is 27 gold at place A. All right?
Okay.
These guys
have a
run a risk... both when they immediately after the initial endeavor or after subsequent adventures have occurred, they have a risk of losing their investment.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Okay.
Right?
But it's
so
fairly.
There was a can I get a bank record for my investment? Like can I get like a bank note that says I
sure,
have,
but
okay.
it's only valid at that bank.
Sure. But that makes sense,
yeah.
though.
It doesn't allow you to go to a bank in a different city and go like, oh, hi, I have, like, this amount invested. Can I have it here? Probably not.
And
because people
work.
Don't travel. So, therefore...
I'll work for my last downtime. So I start the session with at least 4 damn brass pennies.
Yeah. And then income.
Oh, and do I get an XP bonus for finishing my short-term objective?
Yes. Sweet. So, I am going to roll for your investment.
Okay.
Let me get nice and open so you can see it. Not a 1. You do not lose your investment.
This would
roll
be
for his investment.
1%.
Okay.
Wow, that's a one.
Also, not a one.
Your investment is safe. I only lose 1% though, right?
No, you lose the whole
thing.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
So it grows by 1% every adventure, but you have a 1% chance to lose the entire thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Because investment in merchant banks and things like that is a risky business.
Of course it is.
But... stashing it
yeah.
never 10%. Grows.
Yeah.
Sure.
But it's a 10% chance it vanishes.
Yeah.
But only from the stash and only when you try to retrieve it.
So either you roll a 10,
well, or 10 or, one,
or lower.
Or lower.
Yeah, 10 or lower.
On an investment on a D100.
For an investment?
No, for stashing.
For stashing. Yeah, it's only stashing. A 1 or. Yeah, just a 1.
Yeah, okay. and I
so it's a 1 in 100 of losing.
But once I try and remove it, then there's a 10% chance that I go, and it's just not there.
Ah, okay.
There's a note that
someone
says...
Someone found it, and went, ha, 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 ha.
Because this is the Warhammer world.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who are you? I'm the one that kills the bus driver.
So...
Oh, Dark Knight. So
please make me an animal training test.
But we established he doesn't have that skill.
Okay. That
so one night after you've been out and about drinking, whoring, your dog's missing.
Aww.
Just gone.
I would like a war cat now.
So
oh,
yes,
wow, for
there
one,
are
I
random
John
events
Wick's
as well
one.
That can happen.
Okay. Does animal care not apply at all?
No.
No. Okay.
It's to see if it, how.
So I no longer have a dog.
No.
Poor whore dog. We knew, barely knew him.
But I thought knowing him was kind of the whole point.
So.
I like how it was like I'm gonna name my dog. I'm gonna change my dog's name, and the dog heard. I'm gonna call you something different now.
Hordak.
Hordak.
For you,
yes.
Please pick.
Oh God.
A relative, friend, ally, etc. Someone.
Richard.
He's not a member of the party.
Damn it. Okay. I will pick the
your
lawyer.
Cousin. The lawyer.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. The lawyer contracted some disease and has died.
Oh shit.
Oh Jesus.
Sorry.
Why you do this to us, Greg?
I don't know.
What happened?
Oh, the lawyer reached out his long grasp and claimed your lawyer.
Well, does she have a business partner? Like somebody to take over the business?
No.
I mean, if you're gonna fuck a lawyer, I mean, killing them is like thing, right? That's just the thing.
Hi, Ori.
All right, so we don't have a lawyer.
Great.
Because of Greg.
I don't know
Greg.
A lot of people. He said pick
everyone
someone
thanks
you
Greg.
Know.
Yeah.
Thanks, Greg.
Pick someone you know. I know the lawyer. Rudy's missing. Captain Pfeiffer?
Oh my God. He should have said
tree. You.
Yeah, I'm not gonna.
How's my downtime? What unfortunate business happens?
Uneventful.
Oh, yes. Yes.
What? As it says here, it's times like these that remind you what life is about. Good sleep, fine cheese, be smugly content at the start of your next adventure.
Yeah, oh, that's awesome.
Oh, great, what backfires for me? Where's the shoe dropping?
You're arrested again.
So, you know that money you invested?
Shit.
Turns out some of it was fake.
The coins were fake?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
You lose 20% of your investment. And you lose 20% of your money that you earn. Through income.
That is not nearly as bad as I thought it was going to be.
So now you only have...
Counterfeit
like
money.
5 gold, isn't it? You invested...
Yeah, so counterfeit is really
gold,
interesting
so
in this game.
16%.
Really?
Yeah,
so?
Like it's... So each area has its own...
I'm a metal wizard.
Coinage.
How could I have not been able to tell?
You're not a very good metal wizard yet.
Yeah. But they're all different shapes and sizes and stuff like that.
Right.
So it's much like medieval Europe, how every area had its own shape and size of coin until it became a unified coin. Same thing applies here. and there's things like trimming and counterfeit. So you just shave off coin parts and be like, hey, cool, I have a bunch of coins. Like, after I was told that and read that, I started looking at my quarters.
The quarters have a ridge.
Yeah.
The quarters have a ridge and nickels don't, because there's no point in shaving a nickel. It wasn't worth anything.
Interesting.
Yeah. Good times all. So can we actually learn how to be counterfeiters in the game?
That's a trade.
It's a trade, and there are careers that have access to it.
Ooh.
Yeah.
If I have trade,
a lot of them under the criminal career.
If I have trade cooking, can I work as a cook?
Yeah, that's what you basically do for your income.
No, for my income.
That's what you do for your income. You either work as a hunter or.
But does a cook make more money than a hunter? Sad.
Enough to get by during downtime.
Okay, fine.
Mainly you're a hunter, so you go off hunt and sell the meat and stuff you find.
And we can spend XP at this point too, right?
Yeah, you can spend XP. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll see the broken out moment, and then you can spend your XP. So, what is your standing?
My standing is silver 3.
So roll 3d10.
Am I adding this all together?
Yeah.
20.
You have 20 shillings.
Nice.
What is your standing?
Brass 4.
So you roll 8d10. And that's how many brass pennies you start with. Yours is brass 2.
Brass 2, yeah.
So you start with 4d10 brass pennies.
And I'm brass 3.
So you start with 3d10 silver shillings.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
4 plus 5 is 9, plus 2 is
11.
Hold on, I'm getting there. 11 silver shillings.
Yeah. Wait, Alex. So this is what I roll.
Oh, you took income twice. Sorry, so you get to roll twice.
I rolled,
so you effectively start
with
double.
I rolled 0020.
002.
002, okay.
Yeah.
Alright.
Because you just dropped
that. Oh yeah, and I lose 20% of that, so I'm going to go to 9. All right,
cool. So just...
what denomination?
D. Breast pennies are D, denarii. So you start, you rolled 4, so you effectively get to roll another 4 to 10.
Yay!
Yeah,
double income. I'm working hard.
8d10.
Oh, okay.
How many times can we work during the downtime?
It's an endeavor.
You could work.
Yeah,
it's an endeavor. So
okay,
therefore,
so if we each have 3 endeavors,
yeah.
I could just work 3 times and earn.
You'll never
much
get.
Money.
You might get less than 3 endeavors from downtime. So you might only have a week or 2 weeks of downtime. So you might only get 1 or 2 endeavors. You'll never get more than 3.
Gotcha. And
even if you take 3 years off, you'll only get 3 endeavors.
Wow. Okay.
Right. Just for balancing.
Oh, that makes sense.
It's just you spent that year very lazily working.
Yeah.
I've done that in my life.
And then you guys can have access to this, so you can do XP spends and stuff like that, because some of you have XP to spend.
I already looked at that.
You can probably help Joe with his XP.
Sure.
Because
What do I get for finishing my short-term ambition?
50 XP.
All right, so I essentially just washed the trade cooking.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, what
pages?
You are
so
battle
warrior priest.
Warrior priest. So priest.
Yep.
Like a priest of war.
Warriors. This is
Ears.
Academics.
And you have everything you need.
You
I assume
warrior.
Now
yeah.
to advance
to wizard
to wizard.
Peasants.
Yeah.
As opposed to
river folk.
Jeez. Or legendary wizards.
Legendary wizard.
And they're called wizard lords.
The wizard is dying.
Sorcerer
warrior
lord
priest.
Of Zinch.
Okay.
Wait, sorry.
No.
Alright.
That's okay, we all know I'm pretty much
blessing.
A follower of Slaanesh.
You can
not yet, they
etiquette
not.
Cultists. Reading and writing or strong minded.
So
God, it was so hard not to call out all the mutations as we encounter them, being like,
forget,
I know which god you're for.
Don't forget, Joe will need to buy characteristic advances. He's got everything he needs skill-wise.
He's got everything he needs skill-wise?
He's got the talent he needs. He needs to spend XP on characteristic advances.
Okay, so...
He's already got one for toughness, I believe.
These ones.
So, yeah. Start out with the stuff that has the crosses.
Yeah.
And you need five in each?
Yeah.
Five in each of them to upgrade to the next level.
Yeah.
And characteristics are, for the first five, 10 XP per level, right?
Yeah, characteristics are 25.
25 XP. Okay, my bad.
Yeah.
25 XP per level. You want to increase your weapon skill, your toughness, and your willpower.
Okay, well, I already have one. Oh, sorry, I need five. You said.
Yeah.
So in each.
In each.
So that's 125 to get five, basically, if you're starting from none.
Yep.
Okay.
So...
And you have 300, so 125,
spells,
250,
talents,
and
then you
can put in...
Not yet. I'm going to be doing that when he's finished.
Right, that's more than enough.
You know what the...
Yeah, 5 here, 4 here would be 100. Mm-hmm. So if you upgrade the toughness to plus 5...
Yeah, my long-term...
You don't know.
My character's long-term ambition is to become immortal through merging flesh and metal.
So that's...
So okay.
You're... What's his name from that anime?
He's a chaos dwarf.
So I have 75
okay.
left.
75 left. You can put that right in the willpower if you want. Yeah.
Except, you know, not quite
so
like
that's
that.
Like three extra advances.
What? That's what they do. Yeah,
let's
I know.
Do that.
Yeah.
That
and then you'd
good.
Be cleared out for...
Because of it, they slowly turn stone.
Yeah, but I'm human, so I'm going to do it smarter than they do.
And then pass it to Mike. So we're having okay.
The power.
Hold on. Okay.
Ah, yeah.
Sure.
Mugging for the stream.
So good. All right. So, let's.
So after your month staying in this house.
Yep.
Yes. The road warden has returned, and she's like, "Right, well, now you've had enough time to get your affairs in order, find out what's going on." Oh, my house back. Get out. Staying in town for a long period. I need my house.
Makes sense.
This house has seen such things. Such sights it's seen.
What did you do?
There have been four of us living in this house, whoring and boozing for like a month.
Yeah, I heard some nasty sounds in the night.
Like, I'm really hoping this house wasn't one room. Okay, good. All right.
No, he's actually. So nasty.
Yeah.
So nasty.
Like, you're hiring the silver tier whores, I'm hiring the brass tier whores. Your dog went missing one night, no one knows anything.
I assure you, sir, this statement's offensive.
Someone learned how to cook, your dog went missing.
Yep. On the plus side, you had some really delicious sausages one day.
Yeah.
Aww. I need to go home and hug my cat.
Some hot dogs, eh? Some really meaty hot dogs.
All I know is that I looked at the talents briefly last time. I found that there was a talent that lets you shoot immediately at the top of initiative. So I'm taking that.
Yes.
Oh, that's right. There is one that does that.
There is a quick shot. Yeah.
Yeah. Cool.
There's one that's like, you go to the, you, before initiative begins, you pull your bow and shoot at someone. Mm-hmm. Nice. I'm doing that because I always lose on initiative.
Yeah.
I'm constantly caught flat-footed.
Fast weapons do that too.
Fast weapons do that too?
Yeah. However, if you're surprised,
you don't get
to.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you're surprised if you lose your cool, right? Or no, how does that
usually
work?
Usually it's perception.
Okay.
It's usually based on your perception, so you didn't spot something, etc. Mm.
And then there's another talent that I think increases the damage that you do with the ranged weapons. So I'm just going to... I have 310 XP. I'm just going to put it all into talents that make me shoot stuff.
Okay.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Did you remember to take skills for that, though, as well, to shoot stuff?
Ranged bow.
Okay.
I got 10 ranks in it.
Really?
Yeah, it's got plus 10 on it.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
So you have to get better than what?
So you're now out on the street.
Oh, right. We need a short-term ambition.
Oh, yeah. So short-term ambition.
Right.
We had
so
some...
personal ones and then party short-term ambition.
Clean up crime on the street.
No. Richards would be do crime on the street.
We're not the Watch anymore. We don't need to. We don't need to worry about that.
Why don't we just become? Does that work?
Do you want? Well, we should find out what the troubleshooters.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, we could find out what the woman wanted, or we could hunt goblins in the southern sewers.
Yeah. Let's find out what the woman wants, or I mean, I'm indifferent either way.
Goblins. Or we could find Sergeant Rudy.
No.
Come on, don't you wanna
find which find woman? Him?
The the road warden.
Road warden.
Well, she came back home.
She came back home, yeah. But she wanted us to do something as well, didn't she?
Yeah, but only one, two, three of us knows about that. That one does not.
Yeah. But I mean, we don't need to tell
her. Or wait, no. Wait.
Stand outside, close your ears.
He does.
But that wasn't the road warden.
No, that was something else.
Yeah.
No, I don't remember. Was Joe, was your character present with us?
Yeah, the last adventure, yeah.
Oh, no, well, I know he was in the last adventure, but was he present with us in the office?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, cool. So we're all
just the dwarf and the elf weren't.
Just the dwarf and the elf weren't.
Yeah.
Well, good. Because.
Kind of.
Yeah.
The aforementioned child murder. Anyway. Yeah, I guess we can, we should probably go hunt goblins. That was like a rewarding...
Plus yeah, wasn't that like 100 gold pieces or something ridiculous
probably
like that?
Not that much, no. I think it was like...
Yeah, he was trying really hard to get us to go into those sewers.
It was a test that
yeah, like
required
it was...
immediate action rather than compared to
compared
the other
to
one.
Finding Sergeant Rudy, who we can hunt down whenever we want.
So,
And we won't.
Yeah, you're approached by woman one day.
Mm-hmm.
You are.
Assuming that happens a lot to you.
Indeed, for many are awestruck by my most awesome physique.
Yeah. He needed change.
He's the Charles Atlas of our crew.
She hands you a letter.
What is this? I do not know how to read. Just kidding.
Walks off.
Okay. What does the letter say?
You're fucked.
It refers to you by title.
That's never good.
Uh-oh.
Oh, we're definitely screwed now.
You are cordially invited to the Duchess Eleanor Schaffenberg.
How is that name spelled?
Schaffen.
Okay.
Schaffenberg.
Okay.
Yeah. Schaffenberg. You're cordially invited to call upon the Duchess at her residence.
Oh, good. I like a party.
I'm not with you.
We should all go.
The sensible thing would be to inform my companions of such an invitation.
Bring your friends.
Oh.
P.S.
Doesn't really leave me much of an option to go on my own.
Just gonna draw a little mustache on, look all really fancy.
Yeah. I do none of that.
Just grab a monocle,
put it in place.
So you head to the Duchess.
Yes.
Yeah. With my three companions in tow.
Yay.
I'm going to wear my... I'm going to look very bounty hunter-y.
You're not taking anyone else? Oh, I guess I'll take the stupid dwarf.
That's up to you.
And the elf. Do not commit treachery tonight! Damn it.
Whose house are we going to? The Duchess?
Yeah.
Sorry, who's
you're going to a Duchess's
house.
I believe the elf is Childstabber and the dwarf is Redbeard.
So these are two characters who we have parted ways with. They're part of the Watch. Like
they
used
were
to be.
With you.
Yes.
They were
members of
incarcerated
our
with you.
Yes.
Yes.
They got initially involved in the riot. They got blamed for the same issues. They got incarcerated and sentenced, and were pardoned. However, they were not with you in the office.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I see.
Because they're an elven dwarf, and they can't be trusted.
Yeah.
Dwarf. It's gonna be trusted. Yeah.
But not that dwarf.
Not that dwarf.
He's a slayer. Of course he can be trusted.
I don't know.
So it's the four of us and two of
them. He'll take all your secrets to the grave with him.
And well, that's good, because that's where all the bodies are.
If he gets his way, the grave will be really quickly, too. He's a slayer. He wants to die. Inglorious battle.
I remember you
try to stab him. Because if you try to stab him, he will fuck you up.
Oh. Yep, it's not glorious battle.
Yep. Fuck you up, bud.
Yeah, someone's got a weapon skill of like a chance to with like 70.
Is that what the dwarf's weapon skill is?
No, weapons. His weapon skill plus his melee basic is 70. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mine's only 65, but that's crazy. I'm joking. It's not.
Mine is like 50.
I'm at 43.
Yeah, but you're not dwarves.
Yeah, right.
Sorry, my weapon skill is 49, and my ballistic skill is 45.
Wow. Yeah, you're not a dwarf. You don't start with 2d10 plus.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fair.
It's a.
All right. Anyways,
you don't start with 2d10 plus 30.
Wow, that's a dwarf thing.
Yeah. So that's you take him along.
Yeah.
Or at least, you know, probably the elf. He knows how to, like...
Party?
No, he knows how to act in front of nobility.
Ah, well, there you go.
So, noble, elf, scumbags.
I feel like I would just, like,
you're
go
a peasant.
To the kitchen. Yeah, I would just, like, arrive and then go to the kitchen.
You're like that little mouse in Ratatouille. You're gonna teach the cooks there. Yeah, why not? You're gonna go in someone else's kitchen and just be like, I can cook better than you, bitch.
So, when you arrive, you are escorted into a parlor. And, asked to wait with a guard watching you. Because, you know, they don't trust you because you're peasants. Well, most of you are peasants.
You. So, Roy, I'm pretty untrustworthy.
Mike, I have a question. Your family, like, your noble family, are they present there or is it just him?
As far as I know, it's just me.
Okay.
My family doesn't want anything to do with me.
Okay.
I do not believe it is your place to be asking about such matters.
It's just a question.
He gets the backhand.
That's a good point now. You need to buy some better clothing.
That's true.
Right?
I need to buy some clothing.
If you dress... in good clothing, like fine clothing, your status counts as one level higher.
Okay.
For the purpose of intractable things. So you would count as gold rather than silver. No, it's only because
I'm
a noble.
Brass
okay.
Right now.
Okay.
Oh,
so, I'd be
no,
silver.
You're silver. You're silver.
It says brass on my sheet.
Yeah, but. Okay, you're whatever it was.
Wizard's level.
Wizard level is whatever.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. So, yeah, it's you count as, like, the next level up.
Okay.
Well, not for income or anything like that. So, after a while, a finely dressed woman walks in.
Damn.
Greets
finally
you.
Dressed, not finely looking.
Yeah,
oh,
finely dressed.
Fine.
She's quite old.
Okay.
She's fairly attractive.
Like, fairly attractive, like...
Don't make him describe it. Don't make him describe it. Just fill in your own details, Richard.
All right, so she's
whatever
Natalie Portman.
Yeah.
She's
fairly
Natalie
attractive.
Portman.
Character's view.
It's whatever
to.
Your character's preferences
yeah.
are.
Yeah. Not my preferences, your
but
preferences.
Older. She is universally attractive.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good afternoon. I Giggity. Wish to hold a dinner party.
I thought that's what we were at.
No.
Okay.